Life cycle assessment, or in short LCA, is the most well-known method for analyzing environmental sustainability. In this clip, I will explain you how this works. Let's start with the basis of LCA, which is the life cycle. Here I mean the life cycle of the product of interest. The life cycle of any product starts with the resources that are necessary to produce the product. And it goes until the deposition of the product after it has been used. For example, a plastic bottle. For an LCA analysis, we should know where the plastic is originating from. Is it from fossil crude oil, or have the manufacturers used plant-based plastic? So which resources have been used to make it? How was it made? And what happens after I finished using it? On the sheet, you can see the 7 life cycle stages that are typically considered in LCAs. Each product life cycle contains most of these stages. When calculating the LCA impact, these stages are used to determine the environmental impact. This means that you have to include specific data for each of these stages. Often, you reason from the product that you are considering. In the first 3 life cycle stages, the raw materials are extracted, processed, and the product is manufactured. You might think that these stages are overlapping, but in practice they often occur at various locations and can therefore be more easily distinguished. Let's take a closer look at these stages for the example of a coffee maker. A coffee maker contains various elements, such as the glass pot with the lid, the housing with buttons, and the electrical cord. The manufacturing stage describes how the different parts of the product are assembled. This stage may require additional inputs, such as glue, lining, electricity or heat. The product parts itself are being formed in the materials processing stage. In this stage, the bulk raw materials, such as the plastic polymers, are being processed into the lid of the glass pot, or into the housing. In this stage, first, raw glass is made from sand and additives, and it is being melted and shaped as a pot. The extraction of the sand belongs to the stage of raw material extraction. Other typical raw material extractions are the extraction of oil, natural gas, metals, and phosphorus. You might notice that I do not mention any bio-based raw materials. This is since in raw material extraction only fossil raw materials are considered. Let's go continue now to the other stages of the coffee maker. For the use stage, you have to determine what your product requires during use. In the case of a coffee maker, it is using electricity. Let's move to the 5th stage, the distribution stage. This tells you how the product and its resources were distributed or transported. This can be done by car, truck, ship or plane. Each transportation mode requires other type of fuels, and they have different emissions. We are still missing 2 life cycle stages, namely repair and maintenance and waste management. These stages consider additional inputs for maintaining the product, its reparations, and also the end-of-life treatment. This relates to whether the product can be recycled, downcycled, or how it is disposed of. Now we have considered all the life cycle stages. Studies that consider all the life cycle stages of a product are called cradle-to-cradle studies. They start with the extraction of raw materials from the environment, which is the first cradle, and they end with the disposal of final waste to the environment. In some studies, the disposal phase is not relevant. Then so-called cradle-to-grave is performed. When we study how well a bio-based processing route compares to the fossil alternative, we are typically doing a cradle-to-gate analysis, or a gate-to-gate. Commonly, the factory gate of the materials processing stage and manufacturing stage are considered. Now you know the life cycle stages. This is the basis for every life cycle study.